Praise God, praise God. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. If you go ahead and read my title, it says, when you serve God for God, you can stand. When you serve God for his benefits, you can easily get distracted. Praise God, praise God. I wasn't going to get up on here, but I heard the Lord just very clearly. Here in our scripture, let me go ahead and read my foundational scripture. Hello, everyone. God bless you. God keep you. My foundation scripture is coming from Exodus 20, verse 3. And it says, thou should not have other gods before me. I'm going to actually read verse 4 as well. Thou should not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in earth beneath, or that is in water under the earth. Now y'all understand all these idols in your homes. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Thou should not bow down. Verse 5. To thyself. Notice what he says. All this selfish, all this self. Now y'all understand what's happening. The enemy, that's why God wanted me to go here. The enemy is doing a very good job of having everybody worship even themselves. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm gonna walk this thing out through. And he says, to them, nor serve them, for I, the Lord thy God, I'm a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children, upon the third and fourth generation of them that hate me. Notice what he says. Of them that hate me. And that was the word of God. So basically what I wanted to get up on here and talk about is what God was telling me. He said, Deanna, the reason why my church is not powerful the way it could be and should be, he said, because they're serving me because of my benefits. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. You see, when you start having a relationship with God, you don't care whether you got money, you don't. Come on, somebody. If somebody with you, are they not? Because you serve God for God. That's why the early church was so powerful. They love God for God. How many of you tied just so you can get something? Oh, come on, somebody. I'm going to walk that thing out. How many of you know mega churches, even small churches? Everybody's about money now. That is not of God. That's why you've seen everybody fall. This is star status. Everybody want to be a star. But when you truly start getting in a relationship with God, it's about souls. It's about helping your brother and your sister. It's about standing together in unity. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. God says, when you serve me for me, I'll keep you strong. When you serve me for me, I'll promise you, I'll be with you. I'll be a friend to your friends and an enemy to your enemies. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. He said, but when you serve me for my benefits, that's how the enemy gets in. Come on, somebody. I'm talking up in here. That's how the enemy gets in, because now let me tell you what God said. Let me slow myself down. I get excited. God said, remember when you first started? Well, come on, somebody. I can remember that too. You had a zeal out of this world. Come on, somebody. I mean, you want to tell everybody about God. You was in your Bible. You wouldn't miss church. You wouldn't miss Bible study. But boy, when you start getting his benefits, oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Whether it was a husband, a wife, a car, a home. How many of you, when you start getting the benefits, I don't have time for Bible study. I don't have time to go to church. I don't have time for this. Y'all get my drift. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. God says they started worshiping the creations more than the creator. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. He said, Deanna, if they return back to me with a whole heart, all God wants is you to serve him. Come on, somebody. To the best of your ability. He's not asking you to be perfect, but he says, strive towards perfection. Give me the best version of you. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. God wants the best version of yourself. I bet you give it to that job. I bet you give it to that man. I bet you give it to that woman. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah up in here. You got to give God the best version of you. God, I'll serve you with or without. God, I serve you when you sin and you don't sin. God, I serve you when you don't come. Come on, somebody. And then let me go ahead and shatter this thing. A lot of you say, well, I don't hear God. God hasn't answered me. Uh-oh, can I tell you something? No is an answer. Hello? Do you understand what I'm saying? Well, I didn't hear from God. That means your answer is no. So God will always answer you. I think sometimes we don't like hearing no. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I'm telling you what God says. We got to return to him with a whole heart. That means just foundation, biblical principles. God, I will serve you just because you're God, because that's what you created me to do. We have to go back to biblical worshiping. Worshiping is not getting in church, and I'm going to say it, and then hollering and shouting and dancing, and really, it's not even authentic. God wants authentic worship. What is authentic worship? I'm talking about when you praising him and you don't have a reason to praise him. You serve him and you don't have a reason to serve him. Most people are just serving God for the benefits and the blessings. And that's why you don't have a foundation. Well, come on, somebody. I said it the other day. The foundation is cracked. Whenever you have a cracked foundation, that means things get in that shouldn't be there. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. God said we need to come back to the beginning. We got to come back to the oracles of God. When you first loved God. Do you remember when you first loved God? Come on, somebody. Don't fool me now. And definitely don't fool yourself. We got to go back to that when we first met him, when he first came into our life, when he first saved us, when we first was obedient, when we first loved him all our heart. We didn't have make excuses. We was doing what he told us to do, how he told us to do it. And it wasn't an inconvenience. Oh, come on, somebody. I just said something. Because most people would not serve God if it's an inconvenience. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I know it's the truth. So that's all God wanted me to tell you guys. God bless you. God keep you. We have to do better. And I put myself in. We all have to do better. Be better. That's all God wants. That's somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to his name. They tried to cut me off, you guys. They don't like when I spit that fire. All right. So God bless you. God keep you. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. Roll out soldiers, for that is who you are. God bless.